Hello, welcome back for our second video of 1971. Our second video of 1970 was The Vampire Lovers, and if you watched last week, you know that this beginning of 1971, we're going to be doing sequels or directly related movies to those movies in 1970. So, this is the next movie in the Karstein or Carmilla trilogy. The first was The Vampire Lovers, and the second is Lust for a Vampire. If you watch the Vampire Lovers video, you know that Carmilla, the novella, was written by an Irish author, and it was a story that came out more than 20 years before the story of Dracula. So Carmilla is kind of the original vampire fiction story. And you may also know that Hammer made a whole string of Dracula movies. And in 1970, they decided they're also going to tap into the Carmilla story. So here's the second one, Lust for a Vampire. Now, I just watched it for the second time last night, because the first time I watched it, I didn't like it very much. And I realized before I review it, I needed a fresh look, because when I first watched it, I think it was the second ever Hammer movie that I watched, and I don't think I really totally got what Hammer was all about until I watched more. Now at this point, I think I've watched 40 or 50 Hammer movies, so I feel like I pretty much get it at this point. And while I still don't think this is a super strong movie, I am gonna give it a 6 out of 10 because I enjoyed it for what it was. Now, some people that didn't enjoy it were director Jimmy Sangster and top-billed actor Ralph Bates, both on record of saying that it was no good. I forget Jimmy Sangster's exact quote. I think he said something like, "I should have never done it," or "it was a mistake," or something like that. And Ralph Bates said it was the worst movie he was ever in. So, let's talk a little bit more about this. Jimmy Sangster, he wrote over 40 movies. He only ever directed 3. And of 3 he directed, there was only one that he didn't write, and it was this one. Tudor Gates wrote it. Tudor Gates also wrote The Vampire Lovers, and he wrote the third movie in the trilogy, Twins of Evil. He also wrote Barbarella, which I haven't seen yet, but that's his biggest movie. So Jimmy Sangster directed because Terrence Fisher was supposed to direct, and at the last minute he couldn't. I'm not sure if it was because he had health issues. I know he couldn't direct some other movies because of health issues. So Jimmy Sangster stepped in and saved the day. He directed it. I think the directing job is fine. The story itself is pretty good. Okay. In this one we have the Karnstein family, which is a family that lived in Styria, part of the Holy Roman Empire at the time. And they were vampires, and even though they had been killed in the past, in this particular story, once every 40 years they have the chance to reincarnate. So at the beginning of the movie, some of the family members reincarnate Carmilla. She takes the name Mircala. She goes, if you remember, she goes through these different names, Mircala, Carmilla, and there's other ones. Mircala, Carmilla, another one that starts with M. They don't really use the third one in this story that much. Anyway, so she's resurrected, and then she starts going to either a female boarding school or a female college in Central Europe, Styria. And this movie slows way down, okay, which is probably why it is not a highly regarded Hammer film. There's not too much wrong with it. Here's the thing. If you're going into this looking for a lot of horror action and a lot of scares, you're gonna be disappointed. The second time I watched it, I went into it with an extremely low expectation because I couldn't even really remember what happened because it had almost no impression on me the first time I watched it. The first time I watched it, I didn't know who Ralph Bates was, and the second time, now I've seen the horror of Frankenstein, which had Ralph Bates playing Frankenstein. And I also watched Taste of the Blood of Dracula. And Ralph Bates had a great role in Taste of the Blood of Dracula, where he is the man that resurrects Dracula. In both of those movies, he plays a total jerk. And he's really good at that. In this movie, he plays actually a role that was supposed to be played by Peter Cushing, but then Peter Cushing ended up not doing it. Which is interesting, because he also played Frankenstein, which is a role made popular by Peter Cushing. Ralph Bates kind of is one of the younger faces of Hammer. He's a 70s Hammer actor, as opposed to like Peter Cushing and Christopher Lee were all through the 60s and even the late 50s. Anyway, in this movie, Ralph Bates plays basically a nerdy guy obsessed with the Karnstein family, and he wants to worship them. I'm not going to really give you too many spoilers in this. I'm not going to tell you what happens to him, although I was a little bit disappointed that Ralph Bates was not in more of the movie. I'll say that. This story is really more of a love story between Carmilla and all the people that fall in love with her. Also surprising is that Ralph Bates, even though receives top billing, is not the main character. It's not even on the poster if you take a look. That's not him there. I think that's Michael Johnson, although I could be off on that. But this main character, the main actor who plays the main character here, he's actually only ever been in 3 movies, and this was his biggest one, and this is not that big of a movie. So, the only other thing I really want to say about this is that it feels like a drama horror sandwich. The beginning has a really cool resurrection scene, and at the end, you have people, killing the vampires. The whole middle part is like a love story. And I think that throws a lot of people off for this one. So, 6 out of 10 for Lust of a Vampire. Lust for a Vampire, I should say. Next week, we're going to do Twins of Evil, which came out the same year. It's the third in the Karnstein-Carmilla trilogy. And I'm going to rewatch it before I make that video, but the first time I watched the trilogy, Twins of Evil was my favorite. So I'm looking forward to getting back into that one. So until then, take care.